Panacea, and welcome to the episode of Space Engineers. Today we're going to look at the extended research systems by ERA? Or something like that. We're also going to take a look at the NPC Android crew and the next part of the Daily Needs MK4 by Stoli. Or Stoli. Meh. So anyway, how about we head over to the hangar and take a look at them? I knew I forgot something. Yeah, the tiered mod has had another addition. The compact refinery is the same as tier 5. However, it's not as good. It's more compact, but you can't upgrade it, and it's not as efficient. But if we bring up the stuff, bonk. Best refineries, all ours. Compact version, this version is less power efficient. In other words, it doesn't produce as much ore per watt it uses as the normal tier 5 one does. And its speed is only 2. Compared to... this one, which is 8.2. So its speed is only equal to a tier 2. I think it has a higher yield. Yeah, it gets more ore out of it, but its speed is the same as the tier 2. And it can't be sped up or anything like that. Which is a shame, but oh well. Let's see, it does use the blast furnace model. This looks pretty good. Anywho, how about we move on to the NPCs? You got the red guy. You can't really choose his colour. We also got the yellow guy and the blue guy. Now these guys are actually quite amazing to have. Why? Well, first of all, let's take the blue guy, who is the production bot. And you see on the right, it says gas output increased by, well, increased up to 300%, and drill output increased to 200%, which means drills are twice as efficient, and you produce three times as much gas. So that's pretty good. And then you got the engineering one. It just doesn't say production is anywhere. Wait, hold on. Yeah, it does. You got the engineering systems. This guy increases power output by 300%. Well, doesn't increase it. You know what I mean. It's 3 times as much power out of each reactor, and everything only uses half the amount of power that everything else does. That makes sense. It's half as much power as normal. So, you know, pretty handy. You get a lot more power out of your refineries, and you don't need as much power. It's very useful. And then you've got the weapon systems. Or those called combat mobility. You're the one that actually needs power, oddly enough. Wait a minute. You can be controlled? What about you? No. What about you? No. This guy could actually act as a pilot. Interesting. Anyway, thrust output is tripled and gyro output's also tripled. So you'll need a third of the gyroscopes and a third of the thrusters. In fact, this thing would be very useful on the Earth Eater. Wherever the frickadoo that thing's gone. Oh, it's over there. I'll see it. Too dark. That's because of the realistic shadows, Matt. Nee. Bouncy. So yeah, you'll be able to set off quicker and turn quicker using the same amount of gyros. Now as for their build cost, the production one, which is blue, is expensive. Just as expensive, and also expensive. Yeah, they're all the same. 60 steel plates, 50 missile grids, 20 gravity components, 20 detector components, 120 power cells, 1,000 superconductors, 300 computers, and 40 construction components. The same resource cost as a jump drive. So, you know, they're not cheap, especially considering how much of a boost they give you. It's like it's disappearing for some reason. So yeah, it's actually quite handy. Especially with this guy being remote control. Definitely use him on the Earth Eater. Mainly for the thrusters and gyros. This thing is heavy. Hmm. That would also be handy, but I think I've got... I think 6 azimuth fusion reactors would be good enough. And since it is a massive mining ship, this guy could be quite useful as well. To improve the drills. You have a funny-looking head, though. So yeah, that's the NPCs. So anyway, next we move on to the research station. There are 3 different blocks, there's only 2. I just placed the same one down twice. So this one isn't fully implemented yet. Okay, I think this might actually be fully implemented. But the things this thing produces, since it is an assembler, these the blueprints are meant to only be storable in that data storage thing. As you can see, each one produces... These require research materials, but they all do different levels. All these produces a blueprint, as you can see. Now this may be some sort of progression. So this mod installed, when you go into survival, a lot of blocks are locked and you're unable to use them. Thus you use this research lab to unlock everything. Now you're not going to be completely powerless either. Because only... I think it's nuclear reactors that are locked. I get small reactor there, you get large reactor of this one. Not sure. And I need to go into survival mode to check that out. And how do you get the research materials? Oh, that's quite easy. You just go to a normal assembler. And you find these. You see the different tiers require different materials. With the highest grade pretty much being impossible when you're on a planet. You know, since you can't get platinum on a planet. These only make 1. Huh. How much did these hit again? Why am I switching? What am I doing? Me. It needs 20, 40. Yeah, they need different amounts. Those are different weapons. That's targeting disruption. That's probably the decoys. Then you got the automatic turrets, which are probably the Gatling gun and missile turrets. Oh, automatic reloading. Oh, that must be the rocket launchers. Crash sleep. That's probably for the jump drive. That's for gravity, and that's the artificial mass block. I'm only pretty much guessing here, considering, you know, I haven't even tried them yet. Upscale drills, that's probably for large ship drills. Upscale grinders, large ship again, large ship. I think that's for the arc furnace. Power saving, that's for a battery most likely. Oh wait! These are the upgrade modules for refineries. That's the power one, that's obviously the efficiency module, and that's the productivity module. I think that will actually do yield. Yeah, they renamed it, didn't they? Then here we got the wheels! Big wheels! Even bigger wheels! And then you got hydrogen, atmospherics, and ions. Huh. So you can't even get thrusters at the beginning. Oh, that can be a problem. Then that's just larger cargo containers. Even bigger ones? Oh, that's sorters. Upscale tanks. Yeah, large ship tanks, I'm guessing. Advanced tanks. What? Item transfer. So that's probably like conveyors and sorters. Okay, that's probably sorters. Okay, I'm a little confused. Oh! Positional marker, that'd probably be a beacon. Short range duplications, that'd probably just be a regular antenna. That'd be a laser antenna. Probably a large ship ore detector. That'd be the projectors. Blast doors, probably. No idea. Yeah. That'd be the cockpits. About vents. Yeah, let's get air in. Oxygen collection. Wait. Oh, that'd probably be the oxygen farms. You know, when you stick inside a ship and it produces oxygen depending on sunlight. Yeah, that's all the different things you can get. And with one of the three mods that you need, you can actually add modded blocks to the research list, which you can lock off all sorts of different blocks from being used, whether they're vanilla or mods. The first one is pretty much for the scripts, depending on to decide what blocks are locked and which blocks are not. The second one has these blocks. You pretty much, you know, makes it work. And third one is depending on your assembler speed that you've chosen for your world. I got the times one because that's what I have it as. So what's their build cost? Data storage. I don't think you'll ever need more than one, to be honest. Securely store research blueprints. Kind of cheap, so it's not too bad. This one, a bit more expensive, but that's to be expected. In fact, I think we should actually get one of these making. And I'll be heading here to... you! Okay, I gotta make a lot of these, aren't I? Be right back as soon as I got them. Well, they're not very fast to make, are they? I can't even tell how much more is needed. So there's too much here. Well, I guess once I've got everything all the way done, if that's using the normal research material, it should be fine. I need 20 to start with. If it's going this low, that could take a while. Anyway, let's see if I put the others on assist, it'll speed things up. Yeah, this is gonna take a bit too long to do. So I guess I'll just spawn the items inside? Yeah, that's gonna be the better option. And that's access to its inventory, so... balls! couldn't really expect it to be too quick, could we? Oh well, never mind. I guess we just get the other things in there. And again, I'm guessing the other things are going to be ready first. Well then, don't really have time to wait around for this. Oh well. So, in order to take a look at the rest of the basic needs mod, we have to switch over to survival and head down to the planet to a farm that I made. And we are back and at the farm, which is fully wind powered. And yes, it's really freaking dark. And you can see there are three things on the left side now. Top one's for food, next one's for water, and the bottom one is fatigue. Sleeping in a bed will put your fatigue up. Hey, why did that just go down? You can get your fatigue up to 150 by lying down in a bed. There we go. Don't you able to do more? And the treadmill will drain fatigue while generating power. 38 years? Really? Blimey. Go up again. Don't it just have a border around it like the rest of it does? The thing is, that menu there is only possible because of the same mod that puts that compass at the top. Which is actually very handy. I'm sure it's not part of the vanilla game. Anyhoodle. Wait. Crop grow is active. That must be standby. Anyhoodle. Let's head outside. Not that there's any light out there. I haven't put down any light for some reason. Whoops. Oh well, never mind. I'll leave this light on. Now let's close it. So it's a, well, turn the lights off and close the door. Any goodle. See, these are the crop growers. And the mod actually changed slightly between me building this and place that at the beginning and then finishing it. Yeah, these things used to produce gravel, but now they only produce water, stone, and organics. And you need gravel in order to make fertilizer. So yeah, I got a pulverizer here to do that. Although this is a refinery. Gravel. So how much gravel are you holding? Not much. Yeah, fertilizer's holding a piece of gravel. I do wonder how you actually eat. Ow! Wow, that hurt! Anyhoodle. And once you do have this running, you go to here. Oh my. Yeah, I got six of each one continuously producing each different vegetable in there. I got one here that produces fertilizer. Which doesn't matter which one you produce, either organic or artificial, they both just count as fertilizer. Just that organic fertilizer requires organics, and the artificial doesn't. In fact, the phosphorus ingot and the potassium ingot are, you can get as ores, well, they're the processed form of ores that you can find throughout the world and on asteroids. So that's how you get them. And to get seeds, well, don't know why I changed them. Here, a pack of seeds requires an actual vegetable, and you need three seeds to make a vegetable, so yeah, kind of see a bit of a problem going on here. So yeah, can be an issue. Hold on a sec. How much do I have? Fertilizer-wise, that is. Why are you making any more fertilizer? Fertilizer. Oh, you don't have enough organics. I don't have enough organics because there isn't enough ice. I see. Okay, I gotta get a spawn for some reason. Nee. Oh, well. That kinda sucks. But anyway, we do have a bunch of carrots. And I gotta turn the lights on again. Nikita. It's dark. Let's light switch again. Not even close. my. Neat. Okay. Let's see. We've got two of each seed. Lots of fertilizer. It's not a lot. Fertilizer doesn't have as much organics as it needs. Okay, seeds inventory. Ah, that's the seed one. That's food, water food. I'll pretty much just drink of water. And here, we got 26 of each. That will make us about 260 seeds. Oh my. And then those 260 seeds divided between three. How much would that make? I don't know. Anyway, first is going down a little bit. So I guess I get some water out for myself. Everything's already in the machines. And there's two seats there. Tainwo's already got all this stuff. I have an idea. How much should... cancel. Let's take 10. I don't know how you actually use them. Not sure if there's actually an action you have to take. Hmm. Oh dear. And no signals detected. Huh. Enough that in a second. So yeah. Go to production. Go all the way down to seeds. Let's say we make 10 of each. Why aren't you collecting? Oh, its inventory is full, that's why. Nee. Now you should see in a moment. Yep, it's pulling what it needs. Hey, I didn't realize it was full. I guess I just don't have a lot of inventory space. Huh. Stick you there for now. Pull out the rest of these. Since this thing doesn't actually need water, we should make one of the other things. Like, nothing. So, yeah, there's that. Can't show you that turning ice into water, gravel, and organics because I can't spawn ice for some reason. Hmm. Well, anyway, I am now going to go rush over there before we head back into creative mode and head all the way back up that way. Because the Earth Eater has everything else set up. Well, almost. No, wait, show that one. The hydroponics. Wait, did I show you that one last time? I don't know. Either way, this thing and this thing are the same. One's open, one's closed. One makes more with less, and one makes, you know, less with more. This one also uses less power, I think. And this one actually makes food. Which I think the one on board the Earth Eater has actually produced some of everything. Now I'm gonna go grab that. And then we're gonna head back in space. Well, it turns out these are how you get the seeds from these pods. You get some food. And bullets. And thrust air components. I've never actually seen this bug before. Huh. How about? There is butts on the butt. Nee. There it goes. So, be back once we're in space. And here we are inside the Earth Eater. The ship I've still got to finish. Right here is the hydroponics, which I've turned off. Because when I turn them on, they take lots of stuff. Okay. It makes grey water and fresh vegetables. Grey water. Hey! Take it back into these in order to convert it into water. If you've got too much ice, you're not going to do much. You got ice and dirty grey water. You got nothing. Turns into drink water and organics. Not much, but still. Now turn this off so it doesn't keep on draining everything. Oh my. It's really good of its inventory, hasn't it? Well. Anyway, then you get this thing. That makes all sorts of food. Plus it uses wolf meat. As well as spider eggs and stuff. Got your coffee, vegan food, artificial food, toffee, hot chocolate, luxury meat, not so beef burger and fries, protein shake, separoid something or other, omelette, steak, made from the spiders, space bar meal. Wait, why do I have two of them? Not so bacon, scrambled eggs, tofurkey dinner, wolf stuff, and wolf steak. So pretty much all sorts of things you can get. I need to actually go out and see if we get any eggs and wolf meat. Better have them turned on. Hmm. think those are a bit of a pain in the ass. See, I'm not really sure I eat them yet, but eh, oh well. As it with the artificial meat cutting it. Again, if you actually get it from actual animals, then it's not really artificial, is it? Hmm. The way it looks pretty good. I think the well, these guys are pretty much gonna be a very useful mod. So I'm definitely gonna be sticking this guy on, because this thing's slow as balls at the moment. You just wait. It starts off at about 20-ish million kilograms, and goes all the way up to nearly 100 million. All from mining one rock. And also the whole mining drill thing will be quite useful as well. So anyway, I'm gonna have links for all these mods in the description below. And I think I'm missing something. I don't remember. Oh well. So anyway, I hope people enjoyed this video. If you have, please leave a like and even subscribe for episodes. And I shall see you all next time. Bye bye.